A very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I know I'm coming after one more financial freedom speaker, and my topic also seems to be on financial freedom. So before I talk about financial freedom, a very simple question. How many of you would like to be financially secure? Raise your hands. And how many of you would like to be financially independent? Raise your hands. And how many of you would like to be financially free? Thank you. Now, all these sound the same, right? Financial freedom, financial independence, financial security. But trust me, they're all very different. And I'll come to that. But before that, why am I talking on financial freedom? To understand that, I would like to take you, you know, into history. Our community, that is the Sindhi community, was one of the most persecuted communities which happened during partition. 70 years back, we lost everything when we came to this country, literally from what was called Punjab at that point of time, Punjab and Sindh. We were partitioned, and in a matter of 3 days, families which were royal, wealthy, were reduced to becoming refugees. So money is important, and money is so important that it provides you security. And including my family had to suffer the same thing, from a 9-bed mansion to a 150 square feet chawl in Girgaum. You can imagine what has happened. So, you know, after all that, you would have found, you know, movies made fun of our community, or Marwadi, Sindhis. What did they say? They said, okay, what is this? They said, dead Sindhi. Why? Because if he was alive, he'll be doing this. You got it? So that sort of background, money has been vital. And money is important. And why is money important? Because money provides you with three different things. First, it provides you with security. Second, what else does money give you? It gives you satisfaction. You know? And third, money amplifies. Money magnifies. If you want to donate, you're a good donor, it will help you donate more. If you want to party, it will help you party more. So that's how important money is in your life, and money becomes a great magnifier. Apart from that, money also makes life predictable. Just imagine if you didn't have money, where will your next meal come from? How will you come here? Can you ever think about it? So the whole thing in this universe revolves around the world of money. So now we come back to financial security. What is financial security? Financial security is when your passive income, you know, income which is not what you're earning, something else, maybe from royalties, from rent, you know, from any other source, could be from subscriptions, could be from investments in bonds, dividends, etc. When that passive income, for which you don't actually run around and work on a daily basis, you don't get up every morning, that when it starts paying for your living expenses, that is financial security. And what do you mean by living expenses? Food, clothing, shelter, basic communication, transport, and entertainment, etc. So living expenses are covered, you're financially secure. What about the next one? Financial independence. What do you mean by financial independence? Financial independence is when you have covered your basics, living necessities, plus you have some money for comforts as well. You want to buy a TV, right? A 42-inch TV, you can afford it. You want to go for a good vacation abroad, you can afford it. So you're financially independent. And now I come to the last one, which is financial freedom. And this is important because from only one particular angle. The earlier two, you required at least one additional source of income, right? You wanted one additional source of income. You have your regular income and you have one additional source. It's important. Life has given us everything in twos, right? Two lungs, two kidneys, two hands, two eyes, two legs. Why not two sources of income? So please work on getting another source of income, because if you don't, if you have only one source of income, it's like you walking on one leg. You get it? Did you get it? Yeah. So now we are talking of the next one. We are talking about financial freedom. And in financial freedom, we go to the next level. And what is that? We don't have one source of income, which is already there. This is the passive income, which is the second one. You have a third and multiple sources of income. That is more than three sources of income. And that is when you actually become financially free. Why? Because there are chances that your passive income also may fail at points of time, right? You bought a beautiful property, you put it on rent, and you were happy. And then what happened suddenly to that passive income? The tenant left. It was vacant for almost 1 year. What happened to you? What happens to your living? Did you get what I'm saying? So financial freedom is when you take it to the absolute next level, you have multiple sources, you have created multiple sources of passive income. So now coming to, you know, freedom. When we talk of freedom, what is freedom? So freedom basically is what? Anybody here? You don't work for money. Freedom is basically a feeling. To give you a small example, I was doing a training in a very in ITC Gardenia, you know, when it was brand new 7 years back, when we were having a group of managers there, and everybody had come after lunch, and I asked them, how do you like the hotel? How do you like to stay here? You know, none of them were staying there. So I gave them a proposal. You can stay here at my cost, but on one condition. And what was the condition? The condition is, you've come alone, you stay alone, number one. Number two, you can't leave the hotel for the next 3 days. Is it acceptable? Why? What happened? Why are you getting a lump in your throat? That lump in your throat, that choking feeling what you got just now when I told you that you cannot leave, you know, that is freedom. And that exactly is what happens to you when your six-year-old comes and pulls at you, your son or daughter, and says, Dad, Mom, buy me this toy. And but you know inside you can't afford it because you are not financially free. So you need to understand what financial freedom is all about. I think time's running really fast. So I'll just come to the main, the three components of financial freedom basically are three. One is capital. Capital is nothing but the seed with which you are going to, you know, grow your money. And you can always understand one thing. You can count what? The number of apples, right? In a basket. You can also count the number of seeds inside the apple. But trust me, you can never count the potential of those seeds in the apple, you know, to make unlimited money or to make new apple trees. And that's what happens with markets as well. You go in for a small company. Now, just now we've seen Flipkart, right? Flipkart, some of the most junior employees have become millionaires today. They are getting what? 10,000 rupees a share, 100% ESOP buyback. And that sort of money gives you freedom. Do you understand? That sort of capital, you know, which you save and which can be used. I compare capital to an egg. Either with that egg, you make an omelette and enjoy yourself, or you hatch that egg and make a hatchery out of it so that you can, you know, continue with that. The next one is time. What is time? Is time money or is money time? Okay, let me give you an example. Let's assume for now, all of y'all have 10 lakh rupees in your bank. Aram se. Okay, nice smiles. Okay. Now when you have 10 lakhs in your bank, your best friend comes to you and says, give me 1 lakh rupees for 1 week. Will you charge him anything? Okay, he gives you security also. But now if he asks you, give me this 1 lakh for 1 year, what will you do? You'll ask him, right? So that's what I'm trying to say. The value of time has money. It has a monetary value which has to be compensated. And suppose if the same thing, if he's going to do it for 5 years, and he says, give me 1 lakh for 5 years. Will you accept a small return? You'll say, no, boss. I need to be compensated. So time is an essential factor of money. And this is something one must keep in mind. The richest investor in the world, third richest man on this planet, Warren Buffett, started investing at the age of 11. I know we are way, way back from that, but that's how it is. The third is compounding. Now, what do we mean by compounding? Compounding is the rate at which your money is going to multiply. As I think Kumar said, we live in an abundant universe. Nature is so abundant, right? So let's take an example from nature itself. Suppose if we take an example of rabbits and we expect that one pair of rabbits breeds, you know, doubles every year. So at the end of 10 years, how many rabbits can we have? Can I have a shout out here? How many can you have in 10 years? 500, okay. So anyway, we'll actually do the calculation. Simple, start year 1, 2, year 2, 4, year 3, loud, 8, then 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512 on the 9th year and 1024 on the 10th year. So can you see where is 2 and where is 1024? There's no comparison between that. And what has actually happened is, as the figures have grown up, you will find that the curve has become more. Between the 9th and the 10th year, there's a 500 gap, you see, from where is 2. So this is how compounding actually works. And compounding is the secret which even now our Albert Einstein has said, it is the 8th wonder of the world. Those who understand it, profit from it. Those who don't understand, pay it. So you decide what you want to do. You understand the power of compounding or you understand the power of paying it. So coming to capital, we've already finished about capital and time is money. So I'll just go through it. Now I'll just give you a small recap. In returns, then what has given, what actually has given us returns? In India, two basic things have given us return. One is property, assets, which of course we don't have documentary evidence because of all sorts of, you all know what sort of deals do happen and structures do happen. So we don't have a record of that. Other than property, the next one, and why does property give you return? That's exactly demand and appreciation. That's only because India has 2.4% of the world's land and has got 16% of the world's population staying here. So what's going to happen? And we just saw the rabbit syndrome, right? By 2024, India is going to be the most populous country on this planet, overtaking China. So, okay, coming back, apart from that, we find that Sensex has given an average of 17% return, including the current one. This is up to the older one. 17 to 18% return annualized is what you have got. Whereas fixed deposits have given you around 8.5%. Your gold has given you around 9%. Silver has given you 8%. So these are the other ones which I've given you. So what has actually given you return is the stock market. And why the stock market? Because the companies in the market are the ones which are growing. And when the companies grow, when their sales grow, their profits grow. And when their profits grow, their valuation grows. So you're basically investing in the markets. Now when I talk about markets, I know there's a pause, right? What do you think of the markets? Gambling, then? Subject to market risk, yes. Anybody else? Political decisions. Okay, we are having one at 4 o'clock today also. Okay, so here, I seem to have read your mind. High risk, gambling, quick money, only for the rich, insiders and scams, luck, very important for everybody in any business for that matter, and of course, investments. And for me personally, I would look at the stock market only from an investing point of view, because investing is the key to brilliance. And we've already seen it. We have one Warren Buffett and we have Rakesh Jhunjhunwala in India. And what we see is money which is invested, especially in large index funds, which actually mimic the GDP of the country. As long as the country is growing, you have no issues and you're going to do perfectly well with that. 1 lakh invested in 1979 is worth not 3.1. That's an old one. It's 3.5 crores as on today. Hard to believe, but these are numbers which are genuine and, you know, absolutely which have given you returns. So then we come to the thing with stock market is it tends to, you know, fluctuate. There have been times in 2008 we had a crash. The markets fell 50% in 1 year. So, you know, you have these things. So what do? You have to have a balance. You have to have some debt, which gives you some stability. You have to have some gold. You need to have some stocks. And you, of course, property is already there. So when you keep on juggling with all these investments is when you will, you know, actually become financially free. Because I always say there's no romance without finance. There's no romance without finance. But if you romance finance, you will dance. So capital plus time plus compounding is equal to financial freedom. This is how the secret works. And, you know, at Wealth Mastery Trainings, if you see, my logo is very clear. Live free. Because for me, freedom is not only a birthright. You know, if freedom is a birthright, then financial freedom also is a birthright. And I feel everybody must work towards it because that itself defines you. So now I would like you all, you know, we all will like to stand up because I would like to give you some affirmations. We talk a lot of negative stuff. And we've heard a lot about that from Kumar and from Sandeep being my way. I would suggest you do this. And this is how it starts. I am wealthy. Louder. I am wealthy. Money loves me. Thank you. God bless you. You're all rocking.